men.
I'm sick and tired of it. There's no room for both of our egos.
One, a young, vigorous stature of a human being. A people person. Affectionate. Full of testosterone. And fury fueled by the betrayal of his own mother. The other, a middle-aged man. Sensitive. And with a body that some say is comparable to a beautiful pony. After many sleepless nights, the moment of truth has arrived.
History repeats itself. Try and you succeed. Never doubt that you're the one, and you can have your dream. You're the best around. Nothing's gonna ever keep you down. You're the best around. Nothing's gonna ever keep you down. You're the best around. Nothing's gonna ever keep you down.
Only one hero will show his true colors. Through blood and tears, and much sweat caused by an extreme amount of man-on-man contact, a victor shall emerge as the dominant male of the family. This is the Helm versus Sherman. Battle of the Bodies!
I met Dave when I was about 18,
and it didn't go very well.
You know, when I met Zach, he reminded me of this kid that I beat up when I was in like second grade.
From the moment I met Dave, I really just wanted to shove him off a cliff.
Zach was against our relationship from the very beginning.
I fasted for an entire week praying for Candace to end the relationship, or at least end Dave's life.
Zach, since the beginning, Zach's called me out for everything. If it wasn't for taking too many potatoes, it was for not taking enough potatoes.
What is this, a spoon? You're in the Helm family now. Start acting like it. We use a fork to eat our macaroni. He didn't deserve this. If anything, Candace deserves someone more along the lines of 5'11", maybe 170.
You know, at first I just thought to myself, hold on, Dave, chill out. Have patience with this kid. Maybe he's just mad that an actor retired because you're hooking up with his sister. But then I started thinking after he kept giving me crap that maybe he really is retarded.
So, Dave, I heard about this new hobby you should check out.
Oh yeah, Zach? I've been looking for a new hobby.
Yeah, apparently you just jump out of an airplane without a parachute. Looks awesome. Me and the manager, we've been bouncing around the idea of maybe a comeback. You know, because it'd been like 7 years since I fought Alex at Barnes Park. So when he suggested the idea of maybe fighting Dave, I knew it was time to dust off the old singlet.
Zach's manager, who really is Zach, calls me up and proposes this idea of a fight. You know, I was tired of Zach disrespecting me, my family, and most of all my body. So I ran with the idea of a fight. I embraced it.
Just seeing the joy on my mother's face when he flexes. I mean, how much can a son tolerate?
Yeah, I flex in front of him, so what? I can't keep muscles like these hibernated.
The thing that put me over the top? Well, back in the year 2005, I retreated to Texas for personal reasons. And one day I get this letter. I'd always look forward to my sister's weekly letters. Only this wasn't a letter. It was an invitation to Dave and Candace's wedding. I knew this was Dave's idea because Candace had told me on numerous occasions that she would not wed until I had returned home safely. Dave may as well have sent an invitation to his funeral.
You know, marrying Candace was the best thing that ever happened to me. She cleans the house, she washes the clothes, she cooks. There's nothing Zach can do that will ever get in the way of that.
I've got the mind, I've got the heart, and I've obviously got the body. Now all I need to do is get my singlet and take him down on the mat.
You think these pecs didn't come with a price? Zach, you be ready for me. I'm coming for you.